The iPhone really was a revolutionary device with its native built-in accessibility features. Using an iPhone, a person who is blind or deafblind can access a variety of things just like people who are sighted do, using something called VoiceOver, which is a built-in screen reader. It can be used with a braille display and in a variety of other ways, but right now I'm just going to focus on how someone with usable hearing can use it to navigate around the screen. So I'm just going to move around using one finger.
MyChart, Skype Wi-Fi, Headspace, Writing Folder, Weather Folder.
I'm going to go to the weather, and I'm going to find out what the weather is like in the area where I live today. I'm going to double tap with one finger.
Weather, heading, tech weather.
And I'm going to double tap again on the weather app that I happen to like.
Weather, Everett, partly cloudy, 72. Monday, high 72, low 61.
So I got the weather for today. Navigating is very easy. If I know where an icon is on the screen, I can actually put my finger on it and find it that way. So I'm going to go to what's called the dock at the bottom of the screen, and I'm going to find phone. I know phone happens to be in the lower left-hand corner. If I want to find music, I know that's in the lower right-hand part of the screen. But I can also flick with one finger and find all the icons.
Writing folder, weather folder, utilities folder, travel folder, stores folder, reference.
And I've got lots of them, so I won't go through them all. It takes a little time to learn to use the iPhone this way, but the effort is well worth it, and navigating is one of the many things you can do with the iPhone without sight or even without hearing.